All right. So this is gonna be a new stream of a of Humankind Open Dev. This is Hold the Fort. This is like the big war scenario, and the other four war scenarios are kind of like teaching, and it all leads up to like this big one where you play as medieval England fighting the Aztecs and the Khmer over here. So we have Oxford, or Oxenford, and we have Londonia as our cities. And I say we fight off these attacks. So I mean, it looks like the Aztecs are much smaller right here. So let's go and deal with that. I'm much more confident about how the combat system works now, so I feel a lot more comfortable. So let's start a battle here. Let's confirm this. So we have longbows. Let's just station them in the city. Anyone else we can work with? No, that's it. We'll put them next to each other. So they've taken the high ground up here. Let's put some shots into them. Did a little bit of damage. Pretty decent amount. Just wear them down. So that guy's just retreating. Okay, so we can just attack this. And I'm pretty sure this guy will kill it. Excellent. Okay, so we won that battle. So there's more Aztecs somewhere around here, I'm guessing. Let's look over here, where we have the Khmer to contend with. I wouldn't be surprised if they have more units hidden around here. So what are these troops? More longbows. Let's move them over here just to like reinforce these pikemen. We'll fight stronger. So they have two units. Can't put anyone there. Let's put a guy here. Take advantage of the high ground. Put one there. So this is all pikemen? So what happened to my longbows? I don't know. Let's put a guy here too. Oh, there's my longbow. Alright, I think that's a decent deployment. I mean, we kind of had them partially surrounded and we have high ground. So where did they go? Did they just retreat? Hilarious. Okay, so they just ran away. Now they're over here. This is a different unit of theirs. Okay. So now we know where they are. It's too far away, though. So we'll do a lot of damage to it here. Okay, so here's some of their troops. Can't hit them. Oh, no, I didn't want the pikemen to attack it. I wanted the longbow. That's okay. Can this guy hit? Good. Let's come over here so we can get it within range. Let's bring this guy over here. Can't reach over there. Let's just come here. That's it. Let's see if I can attack. Attack the swordsman. So they're going to do more damage because they have the high ground. And now here's their unit. There's some horsemen attacking us from over there. Could do a lot of damage to us. So is this guy going to be able to finish it on his own? No. How much damage will this longbow do? Let's have the longbow shoot this first. Then we can have this pikeman finish it. There we go. So that guy's now dead. Let's shoot this knight. Can this guy kill it? No. But this guy can. So we'll take a lot of damage if we attack there. So let's just move up here to this higher ground. And now we can attack and do a lot more damage than we would have if we had attacked on the low ground. So we lost that guy, and that's too surprisingly. Another knight coming out of nowhere. It'd be nice if I knew like what I was really up against. If I had more like visuals. Let's have this guy attack here. Let's have this pikeman come up and attack. Good, kill it. Let's have this longbow shoot here. Finally, the pikeman will attack. Still alive, but barely. Okay, so who else is still alive for them? I don't know. But I do know I want to get to the high ground. I'm done with this round. So why was this considered a defeat? Well, so like, what makes it a defeat? I only lost one unit and they lost four. I don't know. Let's put some knights here. Let's go try and bring them over. So this is building a longbow. That's probably a good idea. Londonia is also building a longbow. So do I need to be in my own territory to heal? Probably. Let's heal. Let's move over here. Let's move into this fort or outpost or whatever. So we still have these knights here. What unit are these? Great swordsman. This will come up to the high ground and be on even terrain with them. I guess we're gonna fight them. We have two units right there.
Zombie!
do it. Just stay right here.
That isn't possible.
So this guy's close to dying. Can this guy attack from over here, or is he blocked? So we can attack there. Even though we're attacking from lower ground, like the guy's so weak, like we can finish him off. Okay. Let's heal up these units. So I guess we're gonna do a siege on the Khmer. So I guess we'll just start moving our units over. Everyone's movement points seem to be gone. Okay. That's about it. They have more units up there. These units over here to deal with this threat. These are Aztecs, I think. Yep. So these Aztecs units are the only ones that I'm seeing. So let's just move to engage them. That's everyone. Let's end our turn. So Londonia can build something. So it looks like pikemen are just straight up better than swordsmen. Let's get another pikeman. We're still building a longbow there. I think that's everything. I because elephants are a pain to deal with. So what does the battle here look like? Maybe not a good idea. Let's bring these archers here just to fight these guys off. Besieged. Let's deal with this battle. That's outside our deployment zone. Let's bring the archers up there. And the deployment. Let's attack the knights. Can we hit this? Let's attack the crossbows. Kill these knights. They're gonna do a lot of damage to us there with those jaguar warriors. So I think that's about it. Looks like they take a good amount of damage when they attack us from outside. So let's have these crossbows shoot. I'd rather have the longbow shoot these crossbows. How much damage can we do to this? Not much. I'm gonna do a lot of damage over here though. This piping can finish them off. Go attack these ones. Okay, I don't want to move this guy. Just doing so. We take too much damage if we attack them. These guys can move up here. just have this unit fall back over here. Maybe we can bring it around. Let's just shoot this. These longbows can shoot too. Good. We can bring this guy up to this hill. And then we can do a lot of damage to these jaguars from here. We can bring the peasants over here. They're gonna kill themselves attacking us. They're gonna take damage attacking there. Bad move. Alright. So let's have our longbow shoot. These horses are really all that we have to worry about. Let's move up here. Let's move here. So if they attack us, they have to cross the river. So yeah, they have the high ground, but they also have to cross the river. And they also no longer have the high ground. So these guys probably can't hit from here, or that they can hit actually, that's good. Let's shoot them. That did a lot more damage. Let's hit the pikeman attack. And that's that. Save the city. Okay, so there's still these elephants here, which I don't like. That's basically it. Let's have these guys heal. So we have a veteran. Good. So since the Khmer are right here, I'm kind of tempted to try and attack them. But maybe we should deal with this elephant, because from past experience, these elephants are a real pain. Let's move over. See if we can deal with these elephants. These guys need to heal. Is that it? Cuts at the city. Grab another longbow. Let's come over here. I don't want to fight them right there. A few units coming over. Can we shoot this guy? Let's deal with this siege. Confirm. It's all melee units. Move up here, and then now we should be able to attack. Or can we not attack from right here?
That's not possible.
That sucks. Let's move up here. Taking a lot of damage. See about having this guy run away. Let's come down here. We're literally gonna die if we attack that. Oh, let's just keep it there. We need a unit as a distraction. Because it's gonna die if we attack it. I'm trying to move these units over. Can I? Here. I don't really know why it says we're so much stronger. We only have is weak peasants. Just end the run. That's pretty bad. Can I move these units into the city? Why not? Just have one guy over there to deal with. Let's move some units to position. These peasants will take a lot of damage, but we have the numbers. Guy over.
That can't be done.
Attack.
That is impossible.
So if we attack again, we're gonna die. Just end the round. I don't want to attack because it's guaranteed we're gonna die. So we'll just end the round and then I guess. Get more peasants to fight. Authority. Confirm. Let's put a guy. Here. Okay, we'll end. do some more damage this time. So they're fortified and they're veterans. If I could move some real units over. Can I engage like these guys too? Occurring. Where do they go? Up to the high ground. So why can't like these horses that just start attacking this unit? I don't know. It's gonna take a lot of damage over there. Let's move up. Can't get to this high ground. So much damage. This is a ranged unit. Great. Get up there. Honestly, the best thing to do might just be to run away. I don't think we can kill this guy. I don't know why it says we're so much stronger. That's in a weak position. Yeah, that high ground right there is just super advantageous for it. This nightmare is still occurring. So we're guaranteed to die if we attack. And that's gonna shoot and kill another unit. I just don't get how, like, these peasants do so little damage. can't bring these guys in to help. So maybe I can now. Let's try to move these guys over here. I don't know if I want to fight that there. Let's move here. Let's move these troops into the city.
Stay together.
Just keep building more units. I think longbows are really nice. Let's just keep pumping more of that. So, sieging. Guy over here. And why aren't these archers still like considered in the city yet? Let's go attack this. Can at least do a lot of damage, right? So let's put these guys in the city. Why can't I do that? Okay, well, I can't move back. Just let me move into the city. A lot of units over there. Let's get a melee unit. Let's get another pikeman. What now? So what does it want me to do now? I can't take the next turn. I can't enter. Can that be done as there's no idle unit? Okay.
Impossible.
Bring this reinforcement over. Okay, finally. Let's have this longbow shoot. So we're gonna die if we attack that. Okay, let's finish it off. Still alive, seriously? Finish it this turn or round. There we go. Finally. Now there's another siege. So we have two different sieges at the same time. I don't even know how to move. Like, okay. Let's confirm it. Doesn't really seem like it's letting me deploy anywhere, though. Finally, let's go shoot this. Keep shooting this guy. on damage. We do have 3 units attacking it. Move up here to the high ground. Okay. It also moves to high ground. So it probably should have focused on the unit that was already weak, but it didn't. And it has on this forest tile right here, and the forest tile is giving it some defensive bonuses. Keep shooting. Jesus, that is so much damage to it. At least they're not in the forest tile anymore. So we won that, because they weren't able to take the city. So it looks like there's even more units attacking Oxenford, so I don't know if I should be moving these units over to help in London. I just want to get these archers into the city. Why won't you go in? Okay, we'll do a few more turns, then we'll have to end it and finish it in the second part. Where is this archer? So I don't get why I can't just like bring units into this city, because that'll make it much easier to defend. City's besieged. So who's besieging? The elephant? I can't even tell. Go and attack this. I feel like these peasants might die. Yeah. Just do a little bit of damage, I guess. So it's almost dead. Come on. Oh, so he gets to it. Okay, yeah. I guess that does make sense. Because we attacked and then he attacks. I don't know if we're going to win this. This combat strength is ridiculous, though. Yeah, I think we're going to die. That's bad. That's really bad. So we lost London, so, that's bad. This is a hard, scenario to play. I could try to siege my own city, but I'm gonna lose there. I mean, we have these units about to attack Oxenford. These units are just in the middle, not really doing it much at all. So I don't know. I guess like maybe the better thing to do instead of having these units like move around a lot would just be to have my units like kind of just surrounding my city and like fighting off the armies as they approach, and then if the city gets sieged, then I can start attacking. But yeah, like earlier I was trying to like get these archers that were over here into the city so that they could help defend it, but it just wasn't letting me. So that mechanic is a little weird. I still need to figure that one out. But this is my second time playing Hold the Fort. I did do a much better job than previously. But since I lost my Londonia, I don't see how we're going to survive this. So I think we might just have to end the game here and kind of just accept our defeat. But it was kind of fun. I mean, I could hang for it. The thing, though, is that it's so slow. Like, how many turns did we start with? Like, we're on like 19 or something, so we took 6 turns this whole time, in over an hour. It does make me worry about how the final game is going to be. Like, if the turns take this long when you're in combat, like, what is it going to be like in the real game? I don't know. But let's see if we can just let's exit to desktop because there's no way we're going to win this scenario right now. I think I might try watching some videos of how people beat this, and then I'll try and do it myself. It is definitely more fun, though. Like, now that I have a better understanding of the game, I kind of, now that I kind of get it more, it is definitely more enjoyable. But I still have to learn a lot, so that's going to be that. So thanks for watching.